Winter in Scotland's hills is beautiful, but treacherous. Rescuing stranded climbers is just one side of mountain rescue volunteers' work, finds Sandra Dick. There is a deeply poignant picture of Lynn Robertson in which she is turning to the camera, a rocky path ahead, stretching deep into the beauty of a glen in the heart of the Cairngorms. She is wearing a crisp white t-shirt and her red and black backpack seems heavy on her shoulders. She's not smiling. In her backpack are her father's ashes. And the rocky path leads to Creagan Etchachan, the last route he walked. Now it is taking her to where his body was found to see what he last saw and to scatter his remains on the hills he loved. My dad was a really kind and gentle man who was content living a simple life. After his family, hill walking was undoubtedly what he loved most, she says. It is most likely that my dad was caught up in whiteout conditions and fell from the crags of Creagan Etchachan. He was then buried deep in snow, which is why the search operation was so difficult. Her father, Jim Robertson from Cathcart in Glasgow, was an experienced hill walker who had climbed all 284 Munros. It was the last Monday in February 2016 when, a few days before he was due to celebrate his 61st birthday with his family, he set off for Braemar to base himself at Bob Scott's Bothy in Glen Louis on the Mar Lodge estate, and to spend a couple of days walking in the Cairngorms. When he failed to arrive home for his birthday 5 days later, Lynn and her brother Paul made the missing person call to police that everyone with a hill walker or mountaineer in the family must tread. At its peak, the search for Jim involved more than 80 volunteers from Scottish mountain rescue teams, search and rescue dogs, police and a Coast Guard helicopter. The news would not be good. Lynn remembers Matt Smith, the Braemar Mountain Rescue search leader, keeping her family informed of developments. As hours turned into days, hope faded. Matt helped us to accept that it was no longer going to be a rescue, but a recovery. Comfort came from visiting the rescue center, to see the team at work and to tell the volunteers how much their efforts were appreciated. One volunteer, Pete, took us out to Bob Scott's Bothy for the first time, recalls Lynn. We saw for ourselves the severe winter conditions that my dad had been caught up in. While we were there, there were teams on the hills risking their lives for my dad. We were truly overwhelmed by their selflessness and compassion. It would be mid-May before Jim's body was found. The search had continued throughout, with teams from the Aberdeen and Braemar areas gathering over Easter holidays to retrace steps and explore spots that earlier had been too treacherous or too thick with snow cover to properly. For more on this story, visit the news article link.